današnja propoved govori o kompromisima.
Today's sermon is about compromises.
Kompromis kao vrhovni neprijatelj ljubavi.
Compromise is the number one enemy of love.
Na početku bih vam postavio nekoliko pitanja.
In the beginning, I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Da li kompromisom rešavamo stvari ili se kompromisom rešavaju ili se stvaraju novi problemi?
Do we really solve any problems with compromise, or does compromise actually create new problems?
Recimo, imamo mirovne kompromise gdje zaraćene strane malo popustaju jedna i druga i onda dođu do mira.
For example, we have reconciliation between two sides, and the two sides are at war, and they make small compromises to come closer together.
Ili recimo imamo poslovni kompromis u kome se strane dogovore, dve strane se dogovore, da drže cene na istom nivou, da malo oba spuste i da onda se bolje proda.
We have compromises at workplaces on the market where two different sides make compromise to bring the prices closer together and then they agree.
Sad bih vam postavio tri pitanja na koja bi volao da netko dobi odgovor, mada to ne mogu se na ovaj način.
I'd like to ask you another three questions, and I wish I could hear your answers, but it's not possible in this way.
Da li postoji legalan, dobar, zdrav i normalan moralni kompromis?
Is there a normal, healthy, moral compromise?
Da li na moralnom planu možemo da pravimo neke male kompromise kako bi zadržali vjernost Bogu, a u isto vrijeme ne pokvarili odnose sa ljudima i tako nekako smirili se.
So is it possible on moral grounds to make compromises that we can still continue to serve God, but somehow get closer to the people's expectations of the culture?
Drugo pitanje, da li na polju ljubavi može da bude kompromis na također.
The second question is, in the field of love, can we make compromises?
Volim jednu ženu, ali pored nje volim i drugu ženu.
I love one woman, but besides her, I also love another woman.
Ne samo da zvuči smiješno, nego zvuči prizno, ne moramo složiti se sa mnom.
It sounds a little bit funny and also quite immoral, I think you would agree.
Da li može da postoji kompromis na religijskom planu?
Can there be a compromise in the religious field?
Možda u ovoj kategoriji ne možemo nekako da stavimo kompromisi, jer nekako ne možemo biti lojalni na dve strane potpuno u isto vreme.
And I would put it to you that we, on this category, also cannot compromise, because we cannot be loyal to two different sides.
Ne možemo ostati lojalni savesti, ostati lojalni Bogu, ostati osobi, lojalni osobi koju volimo.
We can't stay loyal to our conscience, so we can't stay loyal to our God, we can't stay loyal to the person we love.
Ovo bih danas da vas početi na primjer jednog čovjeka koji je napravio možda najveći kompromis u istoriji.
I'd like to remind you this morning of a story of a man who perhaps made one of the biggest compromises in history.
I taj kompromis je toliko jak da i dan danas ima svoje konsekvence, svoj utjecaj, iako je prošlo možda oko 1700 godina.
And the consequences of this compromise were very powerful and they even had effects for today and many years later.
Car Konstantin želeo je da učini kompromis kako bi pomirio dve strane.
The person in question is King Constantine, and he wanted to reconcile two sides by making a compromise.
I on je pokušao da pagane i hrišćane nekako pomiri.
And he wanted to somehow reconcile and bring together pagans and Christians.
Imamo s jedne strane pagane koji su imali mnogo bogova, bili kristno jaka sredina.
On one hand we have the pagans, which have many gods and was very strong influential people.
I sa druge strane imamo kristijansku zajednicu koja je relativno bila mlada, ali jaka i nije žela nikako se nisu slagali sa paganima.
And on the other hand we have the Christian organization which was young at that time, but it was also quite strong in their unity and they did not get along with paganism.
I znate da on bio prvi hrišćanski rimski vladar i on je želeo nekako da pomiri, da bi imao mir verovatno u svom carstvu.
As you may know, Constantine was the first Christian emperor in Rome and he wanted somehow to create peace in his empire.
I šta je on učinio? On je uzeo jednog, recimo, boga Poseidona, boga mora.
And so what did he do? He took a god, a pagan god, like Poseidon.
I uzeo njegove osobine i naletio na hrišćanskog velikana koji se zvao Nikola i tako napravio svetoga Nikolu sa osobinama boga mora.
So he took his characteristics and he assigned them to one of the Christian personalities, St. Nicholas, and he gave him the same attributes as Poseidon.
vi ste imamo bolo koje vi postavite, samo će se drugačije zvati.
So you merged it together and you said we have the God that you respect, but you have to be called something different.
Jedni slave subotu, jedni slave nedelju, stavit ćemo svi nedelju, evo, malo vi popustite, malo mi, napravit ćemo kompromis da bismo živjeli zajedno mi.
Some of them worship on the Sunday, some of them worship on the Sabbath. I said, we'll make a little bit of a compromise, we'll all worship on Sunday, so that we can somehow live in peace together.
Tako da danas vidimo katoličkoj crkvi, u pravoslavnoj crkvi, oni to prilično ističu, postoje određeni elementi koji su pagansko uporabljeni.
So even today we have certain elements in the Catholic Church and Orthodox churches that came about from pagan origins.
Ispravljanje mnogih stvari učinjen je kompromis i je posljedice danas, kao što sam rekao, posle 1700 godina i dalje možemo da ostavimo.
And by joining these things in together, we have consequences which we can see in today's age.
A danas bih volao sa vama da podelim iskustvo jedne crkve koja je činila kompromise. Da vidimo kako je njihovo iskustvo bilo.
But today I want to share another experience with you of another church that made some compromises. And let's see what their experience was like.
Ono što mene zanima je da li, odnosno kako, Isus gleda na kompromis.
What is of interest to me is how does Jesus look upon compromise?
Šta on misli o njima?
What does he think about compromise?
Prvo ovako, otvorit ćemo Otkrivenje, treće poglavlje, i čitat ćemo stih po stih.
We can read about this in Revelation, the book of Revelation, chapter 3.
Treće poglavlje, čitamo 14. stih, pa dalje.
Chapter 3, verse 14 and onwards.
Kaže ovako, anđelu Laodikije se crkve na Otiš, tako govori Amin, svedok verni i istiniti, početak stvorenja Božjega.
And to the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write, these things says the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God.
Znam tvoja dela, da nisi ni studen ni vruć, o da si studen ili vruć.
I know your words, that you are neither cold nor hot, I could wish that you were cold or hot.
Tako budući mlad, nisi ni studen ni vruć, izljubat ću te iz ruča tvoje.
So then, because you are lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will vomit you out of my mouth.
Jer govoriš, bogat sam i obogatio sam se i ništa ne potrebujem, a ne znaš da si ti nesrećan i nevoljan i siromah i slep i go.
Because you say, I am rich, have become wealthy and have need of nothing, and do not know that you are wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked.
Srećen te da kupiš u mene zlata žezinoga u ognju, da se obogatiš i bele haljine da se obučeš, da se ne pokaže sramota golotinje tvoje i masti očinjom, pomaži oči tvoje da vidiš.
I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire that you may be rich, and white garments that you may be clothed, that the shame of your nakedness may not be revealed, and anoint your eyes with the eye salve that you may see.
Jer koje god ljubim, one i kavram i poučavam, postoje se dakle i pokaj.
As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten, therefore be zealous and repent.
Evo stojim na vratima i kućam, ako ko čuje glas moj i otvori vrata, ući ću k njemu i večeraću s njime, i on sa mnom.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock, and if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come to him and dine with him, and he with me.
Koji pobedi da će mu da sede sa mnom na prestolu mojemu, kao što ja pobedim i sebe prosim svojim na prestolu njegovu.
To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne, as I also overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne.
Ko ima uho neka čuje, šta govori Duh
Sveti. And who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches.
Nekoliko interesantnih stvari vezano za Laodikejsku sada pročeta, ja bih dodao neke historijske stvari koje možda do sada nismo dali.
We've just now read several interesting things about Laodicea, but I'll add a few historical facts as well that are interesting.
Nalazi se 72 km jugoistočno od Filadelfije.
Now, the position of the church was about 70 km from to the east of Philadelphia.
Postoji na Google mapi možete pronaći stari grad Laodicea.
You can find the old city of Laodicea on Google Maps as well.
To je jedan trgovački grad u kome se proizvodila crna vuna.
It was a city of trade where they produced black wool.
Također bili su poznati po tome da su bili bankari.
They were well known as a banking community.
Imali su mnogo novca, znači.
They had a lot of money.
svoje tkanine koje su pravili, odnosno paravane, stvari su za Siriju, pa čak i za cijelu Rimsku zajednicu.
And the goods and the wares that they produced, they sent throughout the Roman Kingdom.
Pošto su bili jako bogati, a nalazili su se na rasudnici velikih puteva, oni su menjali novac i time također zarađivali.
And because they were quite wealthy and they were positioned on the intersection of various roads that were able to trade and exchange money and so became wealthy.
Također su srigijskog traka pravili mas za oči, bili su poznati po medicini u nekoliko sfera.
They were also well known for medicine in a few different spheres, but they made a special salve, an eye salve.
Također su se ponosili svojim bogatstvom.
They were very proud of their wealth.
A dalje su se ovu stvar. 60. godine potresao ih je jak zemljotres.
But imagine this, in the year 60, a powerful earthquake struck the place.
Znači, to je bilo 30. godina prije nego što ovo pismo u Liteji stiže od Jovana.
This was about 30 years before this letter arrived to the church there.
Zemljotres je bio toliko jak, da je razorio potpuno ceo grad. Ceo grad je bio srušen.
And the earthquake was so powerful that it destroyed the whole city, all the buildings were destroyed.
U suštini grad je jako bio potreban Rimskom carstvu, je bio jak trgovački centar, veliki industrijski centar i oni su htjeli nekako da pomognu da se ponovo izgradi taj grad.
And this city, because it was an important city in the Roman Empire, was a center of trade and commerce, and so they wanted to help somehow to re-establish this city.
Rim je, ne čekajući puno, spakovao novac, zlato, da se obnovi taj grad i poslao pomoć u Oditeju.
And Rome didn't delay long, but sent a big package of gold and money and to help them out in this situation.
Šta mislite, kako su reagovali građani Laodiceje kada je pomoć stigla?
How do you think that the citizens of Laodicea reacted when they received this help package?
Oni su zaustavili konvoj i rekli da se vrate nazad u Rim, jer njima pomoć nije potrebna, oni imaju dovoljno novca.
They stopped this caravan that was coming in, and they said, you could turn around and go back to Rome because we do not need any help. We have enough ourselves. They were very self-confident and proud, and they did rebuild the city with their own means. However, in the verse 16, it tells us that they were lukewarm.
Zato se za njih kaže da su mlaki.
Why does it say that they were lukewarm?
Postoji aluzija na vodu koju su oni koristili. Ovo bi samo da podijem također interesantnu činjenicu vezanu za vodu.
I believe there's an allusion here that it's talking about so regarding the water that they had, and I will share this with you as well.
Samo se tu tako sve vredu. Znači, radi se o tome da je nekoliko kilometara dalje, negdje oko 10 kilometara, nalazio se grad koji se zvao Hierapolis.
There was a city about 10 kilometers away from Laodicea called Hierapolis.
Okay. I dan danas tamo postoje terase sa bazenima, može dotići veliko turističko mesto i dan danas.
Even today you can go and see it's a popular tourist destination that have special baths and pools of water.
Oni su imali toplu mineralnu vodu koja je bila izrazito lekovita.
They had warm mineral water from this place that was very medicinal.
Koristili su za lečenje kožnih bolesti, vena i mnogi drugi stvari ovako za lečenje.
And they use this for healing of skin and veins and different kinds of ailments.
Laodicea, budući bogata, a imala je problem sa vodom, rešila je da napravi akvadukt 10 km dugačak od Hierapolisa do Laodicea.
And the Laodicea was quite wealthy, decided to make an aqueduct going all the way 10 km from this place to their own city.
Međutim, predpostavljate kog god je toplo vode i kog god je napolje toplo, tim procesom putovanja 10 km, voda je malo izgubila od onog svog mineralnog ukusa, a također se malo i prohladila.
And you can imagine though, from the water traveling these 10 km, it's lost its heat, its warmth, and it also lost some of its mineral richness.
Tako da više nije bilo lekovita kao što je bilo tamo na izvoru, nije bilo više topla da bi lečila, niste mogli piti jer je bila mlaka, jedino se s njom mogli okupati.
And they did this, basically the water became not good for the purpose that was intended. It was lukewarm, it was not as medicinal as it was at the source, and you couldn't even drink it, so you could basically just have a bath.
Sa druge strane, nalazi se drugi grad koji je imao izrazito dobru hladnu vodu za piće.
But on the other side of them, there was another city that had a very good cold water source.
Također su napravili akvaduk i tu vodu doveli do grada.
And they also wanted to make an aqueduct to bring that water into the city.
Dobro znate kako je vreme i kako je vremenski uslov i kakvi su tamo u današnjoj Turskoj vrlo toplo tokom cijele godine. Ta voda dok je putovala hladna bi se ugrijala i smatila.
And as you well know, there in modern-day Turkey, what the climate is like, that water, as it was traveling, cold, it warmed up on the way, and also became lukewarm.
Tako da obe vode koje bi dolazile u Laodikeju, bile su vlake, nisu bile gospu potrebljene.
So both of these water sources that came into Laodikeja were lukewarm and were not usable.
Isus koristi baš tu sliku i upućenu poruku, vi ste mlaki, pala se vaša voda vlaka.
Now, I believe that Jesus here is using the same symbology, the same picture, saying, you are lukewarm, just like the water is lukewarm.
Zanimljivo je redosled poruka i način na koji Isus ima upućuje poruku. Koristi sve elemente kojima su se oni ponosili kao grad, da im ukaže na njihov problem.
What is very interesting is the points that Jesus here uses, the order of the points, and he uses those illustrations which are part of their city, which they are very proud of.
Pazite, i ostale crkve od tih sedam crkava bilo je bogatih mesta, kao što je Efes, Mirna, što su bili ogromni, bogati gradovi, a Laodikeja bila, što bi mi rekli, bezobrazna voda.
There was other rich cities in the seven churches this position. There was Ephesus and Smyrna, which were also wealthy cities. However, Laodicea was especially wealthy.
Zamislite to da su vratili onu pomoć u zlatu, i sad Isus im uzio baš to oporu.
They're the ones who return gold away, back to Rome. So, and Christ gives them this very message.
Jesus im kaže, ne da ste siromašni, kaže, vi ste ubogi, to je jako siromašan, vi ste prosjaci.
And it says here, it doesn't just say you are poor, but it says that you are wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked.
Kaže, savjetujem da vi kupite od mene zlata žeženoga u ognju.
It says, I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire.
Oni koji su imali puno zlata, koji su realno bili bogati, Isus kaže, vi ste siromašni kao prosjeci, kupite od mene pravoga zlata.
And the Kedorians who actually had a lot of gold, who were really wealthy, Christ tells them, you are poor, you are beggars, you need to buy from me gold refined in the fire.
Zatim znamo da su bili proizvođači vune, kvalitetnog materijala, Isus im kaže, pa vi ste goli, trebate da se obučete.
And even though they were producers of quality wool and exported them all over the place, Jesus tells them, but you are naked.
I pazite sad, jedan stanovnik u Laodikeji koji je bio bogat, kažete mu da je siromašan.
You can imagine telling one citizen of such a place, Laodikeja, who was rich, you are poor.
I kažete mu da je bogat, treba da se obuče, a oni proizvode kažu.
And he's producing all kinds of linen and cloth, and you tell them that they are naked.
Generalno znamo da je u staro vreme golotinja bila najveća sramota i da su pažnjenike u rimsko vreme golištanje kačili na krv.
And you know that in those times especially it was a big shame to be naked and the criminals were hanged on crosses naked because it was extremely shameful.
Također Isus koristi i treći element kojim su oni ponosili, a to je medicina.
And Christ here uses a third element which they were very proud of and that is medicine.
Isus kaže, uzmi tu mask koju pravi iz oči i namazi do oči, da vidiš da si gol.
And he tells him, take that ointment that you are making for eyes, the eye salve, and anoint your eyes that you may be able to see.
U stvari njihova sljepoća je sprečavala da vide svoje pravo stanje.
You see, their blindness prevented them from seeing their true state.
Također vidimo da Isus u trećem poglavlju, zaista tu stihu čitali smo, kaže stoji na vratima i kuca.
And we can see early in Revelation where it says that Christ is standing on the door and knocking.
I jedan skolar, profesor sa Notre Dame univerziteta, smatra da se ovdje radi o kucanju pojedinosti, znači ne na kuću gdje živi 20 ljudi, nego na kuću gdje živi jedan čovjek.
And we have that picture of Jesus knocking on the door, but there's a scholar in Notre Dame that investigated this, and he believes that he's not talking about knocking on a house where there's many people, that GDPR is knocking individually two people.
So znači da on želi da ima večeru sa jednim LDP-cem, jedan na jedan.
Which means that he wants to have dinner with one individual LDP-cem citizen at a time.
Također jako zanimljiva stvar da, da se kucanje, kucanje traje, kucanje se nije završilo, kada stoji na vratima i kucam.
And what's interesting also is that Jesus did not just knock once and stop. The knocking is ongoing. He's standing at the door and knocking as a, as a, as an ongoing thing.
Važan obrok u staro vreme bila je večera. Kada se završi dan, uglavu su imali dva obroka ujutru i uveče. Kada bi se završio radni deo dana, onda bi imali onaj svečani obrok.
In the old days, dinner was one of the most important meals of the day. Usually they ate in the morning and in the evening, but when the day was finished, and they could relax and sit down and eat dinner, it was a very important event. And so Jesus sends him this message and tells them, I want you to sit with me on the right-hand side as a great honor next to the king.
S jedne strane imamo golotinju, s druge strane kalinje koje on nudi.
On one hand we have the nakedness, and on the other hand we have the garments, the Christ office.
Golotinja koja je velika sramota, i s druge strane sedenje staro s desne strane što je najveća čast.
On one hand we have the nakedness, which is a great shame, and on the other hand we have sitting on the right hand of Christ, which is a great honor.
Vidimo mask koja može da pomogne da se vidi realno stanje.
We have the eye cell, which can help us to see our true state.
Zlato koje ne može da propadne.
We have gold that cannot perish.
I pogledajmo sada tri načina na kojima se Isus njima obraća.
And let us look now at the three ways that Christ is speaking to them.
Prvo kaže, ja sam Amen, reč koja se koristila kao tvrdnja koja je potpuno tačna.
First he says here, I am the Amen. It was something used to affirm truth.
Isaija koristi tu reč Amin da kaže Bog verni.
Isaiah uses the word Amen to testify that God is faithful.
Isus im se također predstavlja u istom ovom obraćanju Odikeji kaže svedok istiniti i verni.
And Jesus also proclaimed himself to be here the faithful and true witness.
To je neko na koga baš možete da se osnovite.
That's someone you can really rely on.
I treći način na koji se Bog otkriva ili odnosno predstavlja, kaže početak Božje stvorenje.
And the third way that Christ introduces himself here is the beginning of the creation of God.
I time on želi da kaže, ja sam sve stvorio, sve je u mojoj ruci.
And as if to say here to them, I created everything, everything is in my hand.
Ja imam vlast i želim da mi verujete.
I have power and I wish for you to believe me.
I na kraju, nažalost, završava se tako što kaže, jer ste mlaki i zljuvat ću vas iz usta svojih.
Unfortunately, he ends this message by saying to them, because you are lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth.
Prodavanjem otkrivenja možemo biti sigurni da se mlakost odnosila na kompromise koje je crkva u Odikeji bila spremna da učini.
When we study the scriptures, we can be sure that this lukewarmness that he's talking about here relates to compromises that the church in Laodicea made.
A zapazite ovo, kompromisi nas uvek vode u ravnodušnost.
And you can see this point very clearly, that compromise always leads us to indifference.
A ravnodušnost je najveći protivnik ljubavi.
And indifference is one of the greatest enemies of love.
Kad između dvoje ljudi dođu u neke varice, znači da ima neke emocije.
When two people have feelings for one another,
ali kada nema reakcije, sve jedno mi može da viče na mene, može se ljuti, može da mi kaže da me voli, ja da reagujem, to je totalni kontrast ljubavi.
But when they are indifferent to one another, then they don't care as much how they react to one another.
I zato mi se svima ponudio blago, nešto što će biti puno ljubavi, neko pravo blago koje im se tada nisu mogli da naći.
And that's why Christ here offers them a true treasure, a true riches, which they could not find until that time. And this compromise was also brought into a spiritual blindness. And we also have here mentioned the white robes in exchange for their shame.
Mi znamo da sedam crkava iz otkrivenja imaju implikacije na vremenske crkve u vremenskim razdobljima tokom istorije sveta od Jovana pa do danas.
We know that the seven churches of Revelation, of which this message is one of them, have their implication on churches throughout history.
Znamo da je poruka koja je upućena Laodikejskoj crkvi vremenski odgovara u stvari upravo našoj crkvi.
We know that the message that was given to the Laodicean church time-wise relates very strongly to our time and our church.
Ja ću danas biti zabavno da postavim neka od pitanja.
I will be brave today and I will ask some questions.
Da li je naša crkva slepa da vidi svoje nedostatke?
Is our church today blind that it cannot see its shortcomings?
Da li smo ponosni na ono što imamo?
Are we very proud of what we have?
Da li smo u stvari golišali kao što govori Isusova poruka crkvi Laodikeji?
Are we perhaps in fact naked like the message to or Christ to the church of Laodicea?
Zašto nam Isus nudi nas doć?
Why is Christ offering us ourselves?
Isus nam nudi mas za oči, da bismo namazali naše duhovne oči, da bismo mogli da vidimo naše realno stanje.
I believe that Christ wants us to anoint our eyes with his ointment that we may see our true state.
Zašto je potrebno da vidimo naše realno stanje?
Why do we need to see our true state?
Zato imate ljudi koji stanu na ogledalu i kaže, kako sam lep.
Some people stand before the mirror and they say, I am so beautiful looking.
A drugi kad ga podaju, pa prosvetan, možda baš ti nije nešto.
But someone else may look at them and say, oh, he's pretty average looking.
A ima neko stavio na gledalo i kaže, jao, kako mi gledam očajno, bolje da se sklonim, ne mogu ni sam sebe da gledam.
But there are other people who stand before the mirror and they say, oh, I look so terrible, I don't even want to look at myself.
A drugi kad ga posmatri, kaže, o, lepo, ti je lepo.
But someone else, when they look at them, they say, oh, that's a pretty handsome, good looking man.
Ako želimo da vidimo realno stanje nas sami, moramo duhovnu maštu da namazujemo oči da bismo mogli da nas vidimo.
If we want to see our true spiritual state, we need to anoint our eyes.
Jer kada budemo namazali oči i kada budemo nas videli, vidjet ćemo upravo ono što Isus rekao za crkvu Laodikeje.
Because when we do really anoint our eyes and look at ourselves, we will see exactly what Christ saw in the church of Laodicea.
Vidjet ćemo da nam je potrebno odelo.
We will see that we need some garments to cover ourselves.
Vidjet ćemo da nam je potrebno neko novo blago koje nemamo.
We will see that we will need some more wealth or riches that we don't have.
Vidjet ćemo da nam je potrebno spasitelj.
We will see that we need a savior.
I da nismo dovoljno dobri da sami sebe spasamo.
And that we are not good enough to save ourselves.
Poruka crkvi u Laodikeji je upravo poruka tebi lični.
The message to the church of Laodiceans is a message for you personally.
Poruka crkve Laodikeje je da ti je potreban Isus.
The message to the church of Laodicea is that you need Jesus.
I trebali bismo da iskoristimo benefite koje nudi život za njim.
And we need to receive the benefits that our life with Christ gives us.
Ja verujem da ćemo Isusa uskoro vidjeti.
I believe we will see Jesus soon.
I od mene lično zavisi da li ću u tom trenutku biti stresen ili ću biti jako tužan.
And it's up to me personally whether in that moment when I see him I will be very happy or very sad.
Kompromisi koje pravimo u našem životu nas sprečavaju da vidimo realno stanje.
The compromises that we make in our lives may be hindering us from seeing our true state.
Također kompromisi u našem životu nas sprečavaju da vidimo Boga i da čujemo njegov glas.
The compromises in our lives also prevent us from hearing God's voice.
Kompromisi sprečavaju da vidimo Božji plan koji ima za nas.
The compromises stop us from seeing God's plan for us.
Kompromisi čine naše molitve dosadnima.
The compromises make our own prayers boring.
Nečinjenje kompromisa, rekao bih, je jedna vrsta žrtve.
When we do not compromise, it's a form of sacrifice.
Jer tada činimo nešto što je protivno našoj prirodi.
Because we are doing that which is against our nature.
Ali mogu da vam kažem da je neučinjeni kompromis upravo blagoslov.
But a compromise that is not made is a blessing.
I mislim da ima nemerljivu nagradu na kraju krajeva.
And I think there is a reward in behaving that way.
Zato sada želim da te pozovem.
And so today, now, I want to call you
da na ključnim područjima u našem životu ne pravimo kompromis.
That in key areas of our life, we do not make a compromise.
Da ne pravimo kompromis na moralnom planu.
that we do not make any compromises on the moral plan.
Da ne pravimo kompromise na ljubavnom planu.
That we do not make any compromises in the plan of love.
Da ne pravimo nikakav kompromis u našem odnosu sa Bogom.
That we do not make any compromises with our relationship with God.
Jer na ovim poljima ne treba da ima kompromis.
Because in these fields we should not have any compromises.
Crkva Laodikeja upravo tu pogrešila.
This is where the Church of Laodicea made a big mistake.
I upravo ta ista poruka upućena nama, da ne pogrešimo tu, da ne pravimo kompromis.
The same warning is given to us to not make these compromises.
To je ono što Bog govori crkvama i to je ono što Bog upućuje nama.
That is what the Spirit says to the churches and that is what God is telling us.
I zaista bih volao da našoj crkvi vratimo ime stabilne, jače crkve koja širi evanđelje i koja ne pravi kompromis sa stvarima na kojima ne treba da ih budemo.
And I would like our church to again have the name of being a strong and powerful church that doesn't make any compromises but is doing God's work in this world. I wish you God's blessing on your journey.